Welcome!
Benvingudes i benvinguts a les converses significatives del jam d'indagació apreciativa.
Bienvenue!
Hallo allemaal e-practitioners in de wereld. Welkom bij de bike. Mijn naam is Kees Hoogendijk en ik hoop jullie binnenkort te ontmoeten online. Tot ziens.
Welcome.
Welcome.
Wamu Kelegile.
Namaste. स्वागत है. आपका AI Jam में स्वागत है.
Welcome everyone to the AI Jam
from down under in Australia.
And so with that, I'm ready to jam. Are you all ready to jam? I see some head shaking. I see some hands. I see some thumbs. Okay.
Let's jam. So I believe that a vision of love is the only way we're going to heal and find our way through these tremendous challenges facing us today. But I'd like you to think about love as a verb, an act of love. In describing that vision, all of those things where we're valuing each other, we're appreciating women, we're appreciating young people, those are acts of love. I define love as truly seeing, hearing, and appreciating another. So in that respect, love is our way out, our way through.
How can we show up with massive amount of love every day? In meetings we don't want to be at, with bosses who are behaving less than we want, with partners who may not be holding the end of the bargain, and on and on. How can we show up with massive?
Every single session I've been in, all the people I've met, the conversations I've had, it's like love's been palpable. It's been a palpable experience through the whole jam so far, and I'm sure will continue. So I guess for me, that is the enactment of the moment. It's the conversations, the people here, and it's like it's surrounding me. So
there is this moment where we hold on to hope. Despite the situation. And that moment is what launches us up to the peak, to the next peak, to that next high moment of hope.
So. I feel more and more and more, what a blessing, what a gift to be part of the field of appreciative inquiry and change and the privilege that we have, and how potentially our fields of OD and appreciative inquiry and collaborative processes of change are potentially the most important professions in the world today.
So resonance is a moment of awakening through personal story that opens space and creates possibility for transformative learning and ultimately transformation. Resonance in itself is not transformation, it opens the doorway towards transformative thinking, being, and working together towards transformative outcomes.
He writes about high quality connections. In every interaction we have with other people, we can leave a trace that makes them better off. And I think that if we take that idea seriously, that our capacity for connection and the way we render other people in full color through those connections actually retraces the lines, the fractured lines of the world, retraces the fractured shapes, and helps us restore and rebuild and resile, right, in ways that we could we can never anticipate in advance. And so
how can this community do that? We can be as infectious and contagious as we possibly can be using our positive energy. Because infection is not always disastrous. We can be infectious and we can be a contagion of hope.
For some reason, during this session, I've had an inner conversation about the word practitioner, and it just struck me all of a sudden, we need a new word. We're all part of a community of practice, but we, and I'm speaking about all of you, not just our panelists, you're all very accomplished thinkers and innovators and artists and dreamers and poets and writers, flexible adapters, listeners. There's just so much richness, and I wonder if it gets lost sometimes when we just refer to us or each other as practitioners. So,
a gift, your presence and wisdom and curiosity is a gift to all of us.